Welcome, foolish ones. I am your host, your ghost host. Kindly step all the way in, please, and make room for everyone. There's no turning back now.
That's amazing. That's good, but it's a little scary for this presentation. So why don't you just do what you want to do? Go for it, Corey.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, live from Anaheim, California, welcome to the Disney Character Voices 30th Anniversary Celebration with special appearances by some of our favorite Disney voice talents. And now, please welcome the Senior Vice President of Character Voices, Rick Dempsey!
Clip, and somehow we got our technical thing mixed up, and they got the full length version, so it's 3 minutes long. I think they're going to cut it somewhere in the middle. You're going to get an idea of it. But this is Wayne and Rusi performing at our little office Christmas party. Enjoy this.
All right. Well, I'm Rick. I'm with Character Voice Department, and we're going to have Wayne Allwine and Rusi Taylor, who are the voice of Minnie and Mickey Mouse, come out and sing a little number for you. Let's give it a hand.
Tune that we've worked out. It's sort of Mickey and Minnie as they sang together many, many years ago. It's not a Christmas number. It's a combination of two old-time numbers, 5'2" and Sunday. Both of which are very appropriate for the season, I suppose. So, are you ready, Minnie?
I'm ready.
Sing it, Minnie.
Uh-huh.
I got a little song for you.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, I hope you like it. I've been trying to sing all
night.
Here goes. Certainly missed, and they both leave a legacy to build on for the future. So in 2009, we were lucky enough to find a wonderful guy who sounded incredibly close to Wayne's. Really great, sexy legs. Check this out, the one and only Jim Cummings!
Hello there.
shorts on. He's looking good.
Hey, it's
all right.
He built
it. Yeah. Look at that little cat.
He can go for everything. He can go for you. He's
okay. Well, are we ready to do this?
All right.
Here we go. So really, my job in the studio as director, this is what I get to do. All I really do is, these guys are so phenomenal, I just say, take one. Go.
Fellas, we're at the D23 Expo.
Gosh, they said folks are going to want to take pictures with us and get our autographs. Well, where do you think we should set up, Mickey?
How about over here? This looks like a good spot.
Out of my way, you yardsticks. That primo table is mine.
Yeah, Pete. We spotted that table first.
Finders keepers, Petey.
Yeah, well, you losers are gonna be weepers. On account of because my fans deserve to see me in the best light and at the biggest table. After all, I need lots of space for my piles of pictures and foam fingers and signature bobbleheads and whatnot.
I guess we can set up over in this corner, pals.
Okie dokie, I got the table.
And I got our markers and our pictures. Well, Bob, the crowd should be here any minute.
Oh, hey. What's the matter, boys? Not popular enough? Or is everybody just here to see me?
Don't listen to him, guys. I'm sure we'll get lots of fans real soon. Gosh, I wonder how come nobody's stopping by to take our pictures.
Well, do you think maybe we should have worn our Kingdom Hearts costumes?
Yeah, I tried, but security wouldn't let me in with my Keyblade. Oh.
Come on now, folks, stand back, don't push, form a line. You'll all get your photos and autographs. And don't forget to purchase up a bobblehead or 10. No need to look at the knuckleheads over in the corner. Nothing to see there. What?
Oh, I'm gonna go give Pete a piece of my mind. Hey, Petey, it's...
Fragrant flowers always irritate my sinuses. sinuses. Hello there. Allow me to introduce myself, Professor Ludwig von Drake himself, here to tell you all about the latest scientific breakthrough for that miserable case of the fooies you are suffering with the schnoody and the snaky sinuses, with the sniffle sneezy reaction to common pollinating flower allergy symptoms you get over there. Well, it's not a problem anymore. You get that? Thanks to Dr. Ludwig's new and improved special snake sinus desensitizing super spray patent pending. It'll blast out those impacted sinuses like a great big fire hose. Money back guaranteed. Order yours today from me.
Hey, now. Maybe I need some help from my grandmama. You know she got a sneezing agilis like ain't nobody business. And when she let out one of them big achoo, you know her big glowing bug gonna light up the bayou for sure.
And you cook your little buck, you. When in the world did you get here already?
Well, you know me, I'm just passing through on my way to meet my man, Evangeline. The sweetest firefly in all creation.
Firefly? Nothing but flying gnats, if you ask me. Give me a pickle jar and I'll use them for a hurricane lamp.
Oh, whoa, you talking about capturing my girl? That's it. Put him up. I'm gonna make Duke Berry pie out you.
Pie? Oh, my goodness me. That must mean it's time for tea. Clean cup, move down.
Well, I could move down, but I rather like floating up here. Of course, I can always disappear as well.
Disappear? Don't let's be silly now. How can we celebrate your own birthday if you're only gonna disappear, you know?
Oh, I got you. I noticed in the script we've got a little bit with Alice and the Queen of Hearts, but unfortunately, the actresses who do those characters couldn't make it today, so I thought it would be fun if we found some audience members who could play the Queen of Hearts and Alice for us. So, is there anyone in our audience that wants to give a shot at the Queen of Hearts?
Let's go.
Come on. So I've got Brian Monroe and Rich Minfelton from our group. You want to start over here? Okay. All right, we got a really loud person over here, so she's like perfect for the Queen of Hearts. All right, so what's your name?
I'm Shay.
Shay?
Yeah.
Okay, Shay. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to do like we normally do our sound-alike casting. So we're going to play a little bit of the reference. So if we can play the reference here, Shay. Sounds like this.
Who's been painting my roses red?
Oh, what firehead!
Who's been painting my roses red? Off with her heads!
Not bad, good there. But we never just do one audition, so we're gonna try someone else on this side over here. Brian, who do you have?
Got Golden here.
What is it?
Golden.
Love it. Okay, let's play the reference again for you.
Who's been painting my roses red?
Oh, what firehead!
All right, let's hear it, Golden.
Who's been painting my roses red? Off with their heads!
Good. Yeah. All right. It's a thumbs up, thumbs down. I like them both, but I think we're going to go with Shay here. Okay. Stay right there, Shay. Now we need an Alice, so I need someone who's got a young British accent. Okay. Can you find that person, Brian Richmond? All right, who do you got here? Come on out. Stay there, Shay.
We have Julia.
Okay, this is Julia. All right, Julia, here's the reference of Alice.
Oh, Diana, it's just a rabbit with a waistcoat. Curiouser and curiouser.
All right, let's hear it. A little British accent.
Dinah, it's just a rabbit with a waistcoat. Curiouser and curiouser.
All right, pretty good. Pretty good. All right, Brian, who do you have over there?
I got Alyssa.
Okay, great. Let's hear it, Alyssa. We'll play the. You want to hear the reference? Yeah, she wants reference. She's a pro.
Oh, Dinah. It's just a rabbit with a waistcoat. Curiouser and curiouser.
Oh, Dinah. It's just a rabbit with a waistcoat. Curiouser and curiouser.
Nice. Maybe it'll pitch that up and sound like it's going. For the first time ever, this is the original Miguel Anthony Gonzalez singing with his sound alike, his brother Alex Gonzalez, and the Mariachi Divas. Woo!
I know where I cannot go, where I long to be.
almost happened, so I want to thank my Disney staff. We've got Vicky Rondo, Ben Hoppy,
yeah,
Richmond Felton.
Uh-huh.
I hope they're coming out.
They're so pretty.